probably already knows 90% of the things it needs to know. It's in their instinct to call. It's not magic. Our dogs get that from 5,000 years of breeding for that. Less than 100 years ago, this is how people still move themselves and their goods around. So these dogs come actually from a very long-standing breeding history and were a part of people's everyday life for more than 5,000 years. Dogs that you see today are a modern version of that dog. Originally that dog grew up larger size because people needed their dogs to be very powerful. At a time when they didn't know the means of transportation, the more you could carry in your sled, the heavier your sled was, the better off you were going to be at your destination. So those dogs' bodies reflected that. They were never asked to run fast, but they were asked to work hard and to have a lot of power to add to the team. And so those dogs' bodies reflected that. They were about 120 pounds. They were overall heavy, robust, husky kind of a build. And they were very good at what they did. Our dogs are not needed for that anymore. We have modern technology who has replaced all those things now. And it is really races like the Iditarod that are the single most reason why we have sled dogs in our modern world. The Iditarod, not to belittle any other race, simply has become the most famous of all sled dog races. Largely due to the simple fact that it's the longest sled dog race in the world, at 1,100 miles. So you're looking at the modern version of the sled dog, these dogs still pull. They're physically more needed to also have speed rather than power. Our dogs are much smaller and they're of a narrow frame and a very light build. We have achieved that by mixing in with that sled dog of pointers, setters, greyhounds, waterhounds, all types of breeds that have a body that gives them speed, and that's how we have married these two worlds of the dog that pulls with the raw dog that runs fast. Mm-hmm. So not very scientific in a way, just through crossbreeding here, the speed has been brought to the husky. If you look at the running times in the Iditarod, this has been nothing because of the This Iditarod took place in 1973. The winning team was one of the more traditional star dogs, bigger dogs. Took the winning team 3 weeks. Today, almost 40 years later.
Ha ha!